Hi guys, Truffman from Overclocking TV. We are with the
Team AU,
but not really Team AU completely, right? So we are with Dinos and iCookie. Hey guys, you want the highest frequency for the memory. Was it planned from the beginning that you're going to focus on that? Or was it just, oh yeah, we can do that, let's do it?
No, we said when they asked us at the beginning of the comp that we'll do memory. It's a, you know, Corsair is the, you know, Intel and Corsair are the main sponsors, and we figured this is something that we've worked on a lot with our boards, and they are going to be kick-ass in memory overclocking. So, and it showed today. So this is one that you don't have to be lucky with IMC, because a single stick, the frequencies really should be very similar. So it was just a matter of getting the most out of the platform.
Okay, great. So you actually, today, you only focused on the memory overclocking?
No. We wanted to do 32M as well as whatever the other CPU said, but we couldn't even get 6.3 validated. And people were benching 32M at 6.5 and stuff, so obviously no chance, right? So we switched to Titan at the end of the maybe last 20 minutes or so, half an hour, but we didn't really know the rules properly because we brought our own hard drive, and there's a lot of stuff to set up to get the Titan even to work properly. And obviously, it was just too little, too late. So we'll revisit the whole Titan business later.
Okay, iCookie, did you want to focus specifically on another 3D benchmark after the CPU Z part?
You mean after this event? Yeah, after this event, we're gonna focus on some Titans and make some big score if we can, yeah, and try to push harder on the hardware. Yeah.
Okay, what are you guys gonna do with the cash prize you just won?
4 more Titans.
Yeah, 4 more Titans. Yeah.
Because you actually burned 3 last week. That's
yeah,
it.
Yeah.
That's good. It's whatever. Yeah, we'll work it out.
Okay, guys, what do you think about this kind of competition? Like, instead of the ranking, you have that cash prize. So only the first get something, the second and third didn't get anything. So there's no ranking, it's cash prize. What do you think about this kind of competition for that?
Actually, Gigabyte holds some overclocking event in the past. So I think that was the first time they only provide a bigger cash. So I think it's good, yeah. And the first position is meaning for the overclocking place. So it's good, yeah, yeah. Just focus on the high score, yeah.
It would be nice to have more time though. Like, there was a lot of benchmarks to do. If we had 8 hours or 10 hours, like, I know this would be hard to make. It's hard to have spectators standing around for 8 hours though, but we could really concentrate and have a better game plan when you have a lot of stuff going on. So, you know, you just sort of have to cut your losses on these events with the hardware that you're provided, and just do, you know, whatever you can. So that's what most people did in the room, you know. Everyone, you know, Andre showed up and he had specific hardware for the $1,000 prizes. You know, guys were concentrating on specific benchmarks. You know, for example, Elmo had a reasonably good chip. He was doing quite well. Obviously, Zolio and APAC as well, and Zolcon had a nice chip. But so they concentrated on what worked well for them. We did too. So we just did memory. I like the fact that there's a focus on overclocking, and that, for example, all manufacturers were forced to invest a lot of resources, time and money, improved their R&D very quickly. So there was probably at least like 3 weeks of R&D done that won't have to be done for the next 3 weeks. So we can jump next step very quickly because of Corsair and Intel, because they gave, all the major manufacturers were here, so they gave an incentive for everyone to work really hard. I mean, Cookie had probably half an hour sleep whole last week, you know, like. It's, I know Nick Shi, he looked like a ghost this morning when I saw him, you know. Like, everyone was working hard to try and improve their platforms, you know. And that's what this is about, I think.
Yeah, so on the other side, it's good for this competition because they put all the vendors, the motherboard makers together to compete each other. So they got also inspired for our R&D and our our product manager how to make their products in the future.
Yeah, makes sense. And the BIOS are more mature today for this launch.
They must be, yeah.
This platform will probably be the most mature platform at launch than any other. Partly because of this, partly because we actually started, like Gigabyte, for example, started much sooner than normal. Like, for example, P67, the Z77, we didn't really start as soon as we started in 87. So, and it shows now.
Okay. Perfect. Thanks for your time.
No worries. Cheers.
Good job.
Thank you.
See you tonight.
Yeah.